Welcome into this section. My name is Ernesto Tavoletti from the University of Macerata, Italy, and I will provide a short introduction. Bob will present the theoretical frame, Vas will present methods, and Longzhu will discuss results. There is a popular story by a female American politician entering a US elite university and saying that up there it was not important where you were from, but where you were going. Our results show that it is not so in international business. Your home country matters when people evaluate you, and it may matter more than your performance. The evaluation of our supervisor and peers is in fact critical for our career as employees, student, or scholars. Objective measure of performance that do not imply subjective evaluations are rare. This is relevant because it is the opposite of what our community likes to say. Many of us were born in one nation, educated in another one, and working in another one. Some say my parents have two nationalities each, I speak five languages, and that sort of stories about the supposed outdated concept of home country. We like to pretend that there is not a country of origin effect with people. This is especially relevant in global virtual team, where you miss other status clues. Next slide. The relevance of global virtual team has been growing for years, and COVID-19 gave a boost to global virtual teams. Our starting point is the detection of a discrepancy, as we can see from the next slides, in a large international sample between the peer evaluation of performance nationalities get, left-hand side, and the objective measure of test nationality get, right-hand side table. Singapore was first in peer evaluation and last in objective test. Starting from that, we developed a theoretical frame and looked for a research setting in order to test if where are you from is more or less important than what you are able to do in a team. Bob will now present our theoretical frame.
Okay, so our starting point was, as Ernesto said, that the nationality of team members participating in virtual teams impacts the initial perceptions of competence among the other team members. We focused on measures of home country development. We chose three measures that related to wealth, that's in terms of GDP per capita, the Human Development Index score, and the World Bank system of income classification. Our main proposition then is that higher status team members will be viewed as more competent and will receive better peer evaluations based on the status of the countries that they are from as quantified by economic measures. So our study design had independent variables that, as I mentioned already, focus on country wealth. But we also looked at other variables that would contrast with that, such as one theory would be that country wealth actually designates advantages to team members that increase their ability to contribute to the team. Therefore, things like spending and education or socioeconomic status of the team members themselves, or their relative preparedness to participate in the actual exercise or project of the team, that those measures would also be related to peer evaluations. Our dependent variable was just the peer-assessed individual performance of each team member. We control also for several objective tests, tests of English skills, which we feel would also help team members perform better in this context, and technical skills in a virtual setting, which would be important, and also cultural intelligence in the global virtual team setting. So we controlled for each of those variables and tested the relationships between the wealth factors and in country status and peer evaluated performance. We found significant relationships, positive significant relationships, in each of our measures. In other words, it didn't matter whether we used per capita GDP, HDI, or World Bank income groups, all of them were strongly correlated with peer-assessed individual performance. We also, when those relationships held up when we use the control variables. And we found that the effect sizes were larger for the income classifications and per capita GDP and HDI than they were for the other factors of spending and education, socioeconomic status, and the preparedness for the actual exercise. So all of the hypotheses were supported.
Now, in terms of the context of the study, it was actually very suitable for testing country effects. All participants were enrolled in this project called XCulture, which is an international business competition slash exercise for students. So we have, depending on the semester, there would be up to 5,000 business students, a good portion of whom are MBA students, and then some are undergraduate students who come from about 150 universities in about 40 countries. And so the students are put in global virtual teams in a way where each team member is in a different country. And so they spend one semester, essentially the full semester with the preparation and the post-project debrief on a consulting project for a real company. So several real companies come with their real life international business challenges, and the students work in global virtual teams trying to develop solutions to those challenges. And so in doing so, the students gain experience in international collaboration and business consulting, but for the purposes of this study, they also are a perfect research site for observing peer evaluations. Students do peer evaluations every week and then at the end of the project, and that gives us exactly the data that we need for a study of this kind.
Well, thank you, Vas. The main contribution of our study is that we enriched our understanding about the debate whether or to what extent nationality matters in global virtual teams. Our study confirmed that nationality does matter, especially when nationality is the main known difference among individuals in the group. In our case, it is in the global virtual teams. Our results showed that how rich or how economically developed is the nation you are from has a positive effect on peer evaluations. And the nationality matters more even than individual level economic status and capabilities. But in other words, where you are from matters more than what you do in the eyes of your peers. With the results, our study offers meaningful implications. Next slide, please. For practice. Well, since nationality matters producing a kind of a halo effect, so we suggest team leaders and organizations reconsider the role of peer evaluation in the overall performance review so we can improve our interpretation of individual level performance in cross-cultural, cross-national comparisons. The limitation of our study, next slide please. The main limitation is that our study focuses only on team level with the data from only student teams in a single project. So for future studies can either look at individual level variables or can replicate our study with the global virtual teams samples from other settings like a business settings. Thank you.
Thank you. So I guess now